lecture, we will learn about two very useful functions. The first one is hasone value and the second one is selected value. For this, I have created a very simple table that contains year information. Here you can see available years, and we have 2016 till 2020. And let's try to learn these functions with the help of an example. For this, let me drag and drop one slicer. And here I can put one year. So we can make it list. Okay, now the requirement is, for example, if I select single value, then we should get a message that you have selected single value. If we have selected multiple values, then the measure should return that we have selected multiple values. So how to check either we have selected single value or multiple values? To accomplish this task, hasOneValue function will help us. So let's write one measure. And we need to write formula if hasOneValue, and it returns true when there is only one value in the specified column. So the name of the column is year, available years, and then we have to provide here because it's a hierarchy, and then we have to specify it whether we are selecting quarter, month, day or year. So if it has one value, then we should return values, and then we need to provide one column, the same column year. The values is a table function that returns distinct values for the provided table or the columns. I will make another video to elaborate more about values function. I select any year here, it gives me single value. If I select values like 2017 and 2018, then it is giving us blank value. Let me write another, for example, if I say if it is single value, then the message should be otherwise. If we select a single value, then it is showing us we have selected single value. If I select multiple values, then it is showing we have selected multiple values. Okay, so now the question is, we need to solve one business problem, like if I select multiple years, then the measure should give us the highest value. If I select single value, then it should return the single value, single year. So let's try to accomplish this task. So let me try to rewrite this measure. If it has one value, then should return that value, values. Here. Otherwise, it should give us the higher, the max value. So what we have to use here, max function, and then we have to provide the column name year. So then it will give us the maximum value among all the selected values within the slicer. So here you can see, if I select 2018, then it is showing us, then it is displaying 2018. If I select multiple values, then it is displaying the highest value. So this is how all has one value function works. It check if the column has one value, then it will return true. If it is more than one values, then it will return false. So let's write one more measure for the selected value function. Year underscore selected value. So here we don't need to write if condition. Selected value so it returns the value when there is only one value in the specified column, otherwise return the alternative result. So here we have to provide the column name, year, and if I close the bracket and drag and drop one card here, this function is, when I select single value, then it is displaying the single values on the card. If I select more than one values, then it is showing blank values, because in the behind the scene selected values is also checking if the column returns single value or multi values. If I select one value, then it display that value. If I select more than one value, then it returns empty results. And what we have to do here, as an alternate result, we can write max function, and then we need to provide the column name. And here you can see, if we select more than one values, then it is displaying the highest value in this selection. So this is how selected value and has one value works in DAX.